I'll be safe if I can make it there. I hope. Please let me make it there. Surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I'm okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller.
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly, it's bullshit. Shh. Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. And any one of you could do that to me. Isn't that too easy? Too obvious? What if Arbus chose to capture people at the height of their beauty or innocence? She had a brilliant eye. So
look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
She could have taken another approach.
I have to admit, I'm not a big fan of her work.
I do love my analog camera. I should take a quick picture now.
Me too, Victoria. He captured the essence of post-war beat America. And there was honesty about the... I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s.
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century. I haven't kept up with my journal as much as I should. If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
Textbook, or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Victoria, even her school books are gift-wrapped. I can't believe she made fun of me in class. What is she, 15 years old? Of course, Victoria has to have the bestest, newest, most expensive everything. I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell.
I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event, and I want to represent Blackwell Academy.
You have just by
participating. Hi, Kate. Hi, Max.
Now, no matter who wins, this is just a bump on a bigger road.
You seem quiet today. Just thinking too much. Process,
but I also want everybody to know that this photographic world is...
I hear that. Want to go grab a cup of tea and bitch about life?
Thanks, but not today. I have to go over homework.
No worries. Let's hang later.
Sure.
Looks like somebody was already working on this. Cool. Damn, they have carbon fiber tripods here. The ball head even has a pan lock. God, I'm such a photo nerd. So cool to see Mr. Jefferson's actual published pictures. Gives me hope. This is definitely where cameras go to heaven. Oh man, they have those sweet ultrasonic lenses. And look at that vintage rangefinder. What? Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
You can never escape the lighthouse here. Even in pictures, the forest around here always looks mysterious. Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor. Can't wait to watch some more documentaries on this bad boy. Here's the poster for the contest. Mr. Jefferson really expects me to enter. Why? I don't know if I'm ready for my 15 minutes of infamy.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
I feel like you have to pass.
Welcome to the real world.
Just cute?
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture.
Because Max wants everybody to see how
deep
she is.
I'm not paying.
She plays it so
sharp. I need a serious timeout in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
She's so fucking shy. She takes selfies with a giant camera.
I love that picture of Mom and Dad. Hello, Jack. Kiss, kiss. Andy, you look totally fabulous, as usual.
Imagine a world without you. American girls, I'd like to.
Yes, this poster must stop boys dead in their tracks.
Driving a car by the seaside, watching the world from the bright side.
Poor Daniel, he's so nice. I wish I could beat the shit out of Logan. It looks like she's been gone for months.
To all of you, American girls in the movies, no one can tell where your heart is. American girls,
I wish October would last forever.
With shiny smiles and plastic buddies.
Don't need a PC, missed the poetry jam tryouts, and I did not steal that backpack. That's so messed up. I should contact them to find out what I can do. As if I am. I wonder what actually happened to her. You can never have enough ghosts and skeletons in the hall. They should just call it a sugar machine. That would be awesome if you put money in there and a bag of sugar dropped out. Good thing I left my AK at home.
Wondering why she cries sometimes. Talking about her own place.
Oh, I can hardly wait to never be too cool like Nathan and Victoria. Lame.
No one could dry her fountain.
It looks like she's been gone for months.
That's when I fly to the wild land, to your land.
Empty. Good. Nobody can see my meltdown, except for me. Now, who would bother to write that crap? I feel like the universe is taunting me everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarro dream in class. Am I going crazy? Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it. When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No!
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us in our...
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color...
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now,
shit!
Can you give me an example of a
Damn,
photographer
I cannot believe
who
perfectly
this. Captured the human condition in black and white?
Okay, if I'm crazy, I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane.
Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why Arvis? Can you give
I actually
an example
did
of
it.
A photographer who perfectly captured
I'm a human
the human condition
time
in
machine.
Black and white. Anybody? Bueller?
Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why
Still the same stupid picture. Keep it together, Max.
You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad...
Wowzer, when I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question.
Tortured, right?
If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though. I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment. Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
of course,
this.
As you all know, the
it's real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation
so
was
I can go
first
back in time.
Images for selfie expression.
What if that girl so, isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
Can
remains
I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for...
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I'm sorry. I feel sick. May I be excused?
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me after class.
The French painter
and I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind
the
again and give him the right answer?
Fine detail in people's faces, making them... Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular. Mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of Evan. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Yes, Victoria, you still have to do your homework. I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Yeah, I'm not sure I have one.
Given your selfie output, I'm sure you must have about 1,000 pics by now.
It'll take a long time to find a good one.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you. Yes, Victoria, you still have to do your homework this week.
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers, good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy. Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Tell me what to do!
Wowzer, it's happening again. I need a hammer to break it open.
You're going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Holy shit, I can't let this happen. If I can reverse time again, I can help her.
Never even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun...
Don't ever tell me what to do. I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Of people trying to control me! No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone and please turn off that alarm since that's your job. You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
I just saw Nathan Prescott waving a gun around. In the girls' room.
Nathan Prescott. You sure?
Yes, He was in the bathroom talking to himself with a gun. I saw everything. He was babbling like crazy.
Okay, slow down. Slow down. So now you saw this without him seeing you.
I was hiding behind a stall. I have the right to be there. It's the girls' room.
I know. I just want to be completely clear what happened. Mr. Prescott happens to be from the town's most distinguished family and one of Blackwell's most honored students. So it's hard for me to see him brandishing a weapon in the girls' bathroom. So what happened next?
Then he left. I ran out here wondering what to do. Are you going to bust him?
This is a serious charge. I'll look into the matter personally. Thank you for bringing it to my attention.
That's it? After what I told you?
We'll continue this discussion later in my office. Please go outside with the rest of your class now, Miss Caulfield.
Of course this academic drone won't do anything since the Prescott family owns Blackwell now. Should I rewind and change my story?
Nathan Prescott, please come to the front office. Thank you.
Hi, Miss Grant.
Excuse me, Max. I know everybody loves being asked to sign a petition, but would you do Miss Grant a favor and hear me out?
Sure, I always have time for you. What's the petition?
David Mattson, our chief of security, wants to put surveillance cameras all around the campus. Halls, classrooms, gym, dorm rooms, etc. Blackwell Academy should be a high school, not a high security penitentiary.
That's crazy. I get why schools should be on high alert these days, but cameras in the dorm rooms.
It's a slippery slope, and it's up to you and your classmates to stand up here. Blackwell Academy has a noble heritage, from the Native Americans who founded this land to the pioneers who shared it in peace, not fear and violence.
Blackwell is that old? That's incredible.
You should learn a little history about your alma mater. You'll find some fascinating facts. There's a lot of power in this region. I think it helps the creative juices flow around here. Now, before I assign you homework with this lecture, will you please sign the petition to keep our campus from going back to 1984?
Absolutely. I don't mind security, but not pure surveillance.
I knew you were my favorite new student at Blackwell for a good reason.
I better read Warren's text. Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
Hey there, Stella.
Hey, I know you. You're the new quiet girl in Jefferson's class. Isn't he incredible?
I'm not sure yet. I mean, he's clearly a genius, but I don't agree with everything he says.
He does get a bit pretentious, but he's passionate and just says what he thinks. If Victoria wasn't all over him, I would definitely make a move.
Victoria is pretty obvious. I don't think Jefferson is into her.
I don't think she's closed the deal, but she's not the only player.
Now, How do you know this?
You have a lot to learn here at Blackwell. Rachel Amber absolutely had sex with him. Well, I heard that from a good source.
So, you knew Rachel?
Not really. I saw her hanging with the other cool kids like Victoria. Not my kind of clique. But I heard insane stories about Rachel.
What's up, Daniel?
Oh, hi, Max. Could I, ask you a question? Would you mind letting me sketch you? I do put my sketches on Facebook, though.
I'd be honored, Daniel. Makes me feel like a muse.
Funny you should say that. I was just thinking about my real muse. Rachel Amber.
So what happened to her? There's gotta be a story.
She just stopped coming to class. Some people said she ran away. Some say she jumped off a cliff. I just hope she's okay.
You knew her?
No, but once she asked me to draw her portrait. Oh, she was a natural.
Okay, why don't you start drawing me? Even though I must be a step down from Rachel.
No way! You're a good substitute, Muse. Oh, that's a good posture. Good. Good.
Best portrait ever. Yo, Justin.
Check out the Max. Come to thrash?
Thrash? You mean stage diving, or...?
You're such a poser. If you can't even name a simple nose slide or a tray flip, you should walk on.
Yo, Justin.
Check out the Max. Come to thrash?
I came to nose slide. But I'd love to see somebody do a tree flip.
Oh, sick. You're not a poser.
Nah, I just can't skate worth shit.
Aw, check it. We're gonna destroy some rails for you. What do you want to see?
Go for a tree flip.
Let's get Trevor all over that action. You can watch us destroy these rails.
Hi, Brooke.
Let me guess. You want to fly my drone?
Is that really yours? Is that even legal?
Of course. Nobody knows about it yet.
Isn't it considered a weapon of war?
You read too many conspiracy sites. This might be too complicated for you. Funny. Warren said you were smart. Please, step back.
Hi, Brooke.
Let me guess. You want to fly my drone?
I'd love to. I love planes and balloons and...
This is neither. Do you know what a drone really is?
A weapon, right?
You read too many conspiracy sites. This might be too complicated for you. Funny. Warren said you were smart. Please, step back.
Hi, Brooke.
Let me guess. You want to fly my drone?
Is that really yours? Is that even legal?
Of course. Nobody knows about it yet.
Isn't it considered a weapon of war?
You read too many conspiracy sites. This might be too complicated for you. Funny. Warren said you were smart. Please, step back.
What a complicated name for such a tiny drone.
Sorry, Max. I have to focus on making sure this drone doesn't crash.
I'm sure this poster has stopped millions of bullies. And this is where the otters perform their aquatic magic. Otter power? I'm so not there. They sure get a lot of mileage out of otter power. Oh, that's not nice. Poor little otter. Ew, gross. At least switch to e-cigs. Hey, Hayden.
There she is, the retro selfie master.
That's me, all right. You look relaxed as usual, Hayden.
It's a skill one cultivates at Blackwell, especially when one represents the Vortex Club. Not to boast.
What the hell is the Vortex Club anyway? Seems so elitist.
Only if you're not cool enough to get in, and it doesn't hurt your resume.
If you say so.
I do. But you should actually come hang with us one night, then you wouldn't be so inclined to gossip.
You mean hang with a Vortex Club? That sounds like a setup to a horrible prank.
Chillax, paranoia girl. We're not that desperate for fun. We know how to do that on our own.
It seems weird to think about partying with all those Rachel Amber posters up.
You're high. Rachel used to hang out with us too. She was a blast. Smart, not bitchy like, you know.
Do you really want Nathan Prescott to represent?
Oh, please. Nathan is like everybody's voodoo doll. Kill the rich kid. He's all right and a fun guy to hang with. Fuck the haters.
He seems genuinely unstable to me.
Nate has his extreme moments, but don't we all?
I don't know yet, Hayden. So, you knew Rachel Amber?
I knew she liked to party. Fun to be around. Oh, yeah, and she was hot.
What do you think happened to her?
Whatever happens to people who disappear without a trace.
Did Victoria like Rachel? She seems like the jealous type.
Don't think you know Victoria so well. She respected Rachel, even if she didn't act like it.
Rachel was actually a member of the Vortex Club?
No. Rachel was like her own club. She was actually too cool for us. And I'll deny I ever said that.
Let's talk later, Hayden.
Bye, Max. No, I have to get my chemical on and study. We should get you and Dana out one night.
I would so be there if a Sasquatch actually did battle a Razorback. Posters over posters? Somebody really wants to find Rachel Amber. Mr. Jefferson has such a gift for different styles. Evan's portfolio always looks so uber pro. I'd love to see his photos in there. Hey, Evan. Mind if I check out your cool portfolio?
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max. You'll have to answer a simple question. Who photographed the famous fallen soldier?
Isn't it Robert Dorneau?
Oh my. You can't even tell the difference between street photography and photojournalism. No portfolio peek for you.
Hey, Evan. Mind if I check out your cool portfolio?
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max. You'll have to answer a simple question. Who photographed the famous fallen soldier?
Gotta be Eugene Smith.
Well, they both were famous war photographer images, but you should know the difference. Good try. Wrong answer.
Hey, Evan. Mind if I check out your cool portfolio?
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max. You'll have to answer a simple question. Who photographed the famous fallen soldier?
Robert Capa, of course. I love his work, despite the controversy about that photo.
My, my. This quiet child knows things.
That's why I'm here.
You're a kindred spirit, Max. Would you care for a perusal of my portfolio? It's not a privilege I grant to many.
I'd be honored, sir. These photos are great. And Rachel Amber's face is mesmerizing. Hi, Evan.
As you can see, Rachel Amber was my favorite model here. She knew exactly what angles worked best with my eye.
You were close.
Like brother and sister in arms. She understood me, never judged me. I hated her Vortex Club clique, but she never acted like she cared. Her friends were her friends.
What do you think happened to her?
Nothing good, Max. Nothing good.
Come on, Logan, bring it, brah. Yeah!
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
No.
I always get a little giddy when I think about having my own room here.
Fantastic. I'm by myself reading Chiclet. Pretty soon I'll be bonding with Victoria at the Vortex Club.
I think you're better off reading Chiclet.
Good point. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Glad to see our campus is eco-friendly.
Oh, look, it's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell.
What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit.
The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled.
Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose. So original.
No.
Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way. I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way. I could crank the sprinkler up and give Victoria and her clones incentive to beat it.
Sweet. Okay. Nice, bro.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Awesome. Nice, bro.
I need to figure this out.
None shall pass. Capiche?
Okay. Oh, dude!
Damn, I missed something. I better rewind. This main sprinkler valve looks easy enough to use.
None shall pass. Capiche?
I must have missed something. I should rewind. Okay, let's see if this works.
Nice.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this.
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Oh, Samuel, sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo!
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I dry.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches.
Awesome.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was. But there'll be another.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max.
I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me.
You deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck your selfie.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
Just one of those days, you know?
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Au revoir.
Victoria probably played me. I should have played her. Better get to my room before I find Warren.
Hurry, Courtney!
Room 217? No way in hell am I ever going in here.
We took so long.
As if. Juliet, extreme reporter. Dana's still a cheerleader at heart. Nice atmospheric shot. Needs dusting. Could be fun. Glad I'm not the only lonely nerd around here. Thanks for the warning. They live. Okay, this is just mean and stupid. This is like the public DNA of our dorm. Oh, Victoria, give me a fucking break. How sad. I didn't write anything. I have nothing to say.
Obvious, but true. Home sweet home, my favorite cocoon. Warren even left me a little message with his flash drive. He's such a goofball. Ahoy, Captain. At least I know you've got my back. When I swallowed your eye and my parents rushed me to the ER, I knew we were bonded forever. So cheesy, but it makes me smile thinking of the day Mom and... Max and Chloe, best friends forever. Who even says that anymore? I'm going to have to call Chloe eventually and find out what she'll say. The longer I wait, the worse it'll be. Idiot. Cartier-Bresson, Doisneau, Hamilton, the greatest. That's the only tourist picture I let them take of me at the Space Needle. That was a good hockey game and a great fight. Man, Kristen and Fernando were so drunk hanging on the Fremont Troll. Philip Lorca de Corsia, my man. I don't think I could take my camera to those places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victorian vibe. Talk about analog cameras. Ah, Dolly, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time. Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note. Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room. Daniel has so much talent. I hope nobody hates on it just because it's me. I am so addicted to this site. Look at these vintage beauties. Lauren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here. One day I'll organize my film collection. One day I'll get an actual HDTV. You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama. Drink up. If I'm not looking through a viewfinder, I'm looking through a window. Always looking. I'm glad Kate let me borrow her copy of The October Country. I should have every Bradbury book for myself. Instant film is so damn hard to find and expensive now. But I can't help it. I'm analog, not digital. Thank you.
Hard to believe I'm 18 now. I'm lucky my parents enabled my photo habit into adulthood. Would Man Ray call them selfie portraits?
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell. Oh, Victoria, give me a fucking break.
Let me out, Juliet. This is so stupid.
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
Ridiculous.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care?
Don't let me out.
Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet Mason.
That was truly sad. Thanks for your concern, Max Caulfield. By the way, Juliet Watson.
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
Juliet Watson, you be nice.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do.
Thanks. I locked Dana in because she was sexting Zach, my boyfriend. Unbelievable.
If you don't let me out...
How do you know?
Victoria Chase. You know her.
You could say that. But why would Dana go after your boyfriend?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria... Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything, but I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
At least she puts her photographs out there. Unlike me. She's actually got a classic medium format camera with some awesome prime lens. I hate you, Victoria. Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her posse. I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here. This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent. Juliet, read this.
Of course.
I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Almost done. Get the flash drive and then I'll go see Warren.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Poor Juliet gets her rage on. I hope she doesn't kill Victoria.
Zachary should worry, too. As if I'd let that ego-case jockstrap touch me. But I bet Victoria would be all over that action. Or has been. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
He's a good guy. A geek like me.
You saw the files in his flash drive. Tons of crazy shit. Films I've never even heard of. And in a special folder called Max.
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
This shit.
Ow! That hurt!
Damn, I better rewind.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
Max, that was awesome. Thank you.
That was close.
Jock assholes. If I was a member of the Vortex Club, they'd never pull that.
Would you want to be a member?
You're smart. We should hang out more. Now I have to finish this stupid book.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
You can't fool me. I know everything about this school. I cover the waterfront. So you better figure out what side you're on.
Please, leave me alone. Hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for nothing, Max.
Man, I should have stepped in between Kate and David. That asshole was so over the line. I could rewind and try something different.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate. I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me. Maybe I should rewind and mind my own business? I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied. Good thing I don't have a car. Yet. Who toilet papers a bike? I wonder how long before Samuel has to repaint that.
I don't get it. How could Zack and Victoria do that?
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zack yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Max, get your ass over here. What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw?
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop, cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill-kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal, now. Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
I could call the police.
Do it! The Prescotts own the pigs here.
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal, or that whore
right
in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beatdown for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt, and you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely. Out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
Bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Broken. Man, are you serial?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific, tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home. My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
It won't play without any power.
I broke my glass snow dough. Thanks. Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross. This postcard is from Rachel Ember. Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days. Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close. When's the last time I had to dig through Chloe's crap? I guess she's not into Blue's Clues or Teletubbies anymore.
Chloe is pretty pissed at me. I better look for a CD. We had such a blast drawing these together. Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair. Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height. Nothing but junk in this suitcase.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now? Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today. Oh shit! Poor thing. I bet I could do something to save it.
Goodbye.
Joyce always loved her mail order catalogs of useless crap. Aww. Joyce has a little shrine to William. Her new husband may not be such a douche. Uh-oh. The prices are late on their bills. Joyce looks happy. Chloe's stepdad might not be a douchebag after all. Joyce still works at the diner. Is her husband a cop? Poor Chloe.
I'm singing songs about the future.
Wondering where. These books have not been touched since the last decade. I see what. Nothing's changed. Except for me and Chloe. Anything. This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products. I hope Chloe isn't taking these pills. I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me. Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. Joyce still works at Two Wells Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon. I'd love to go to Paris too. I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. Yum, that looks tasty. I do miss Joyce's cooking. And the ones you left behind. And the ones we left behind. Brr. I can feel autumn pushing out the summer. What do you truly want to do when you grow up?
Max, I'm already grown up. What about you?
Travel. That would be awesome. Explore the world, go far from here.
Far from me? Thanks a lot, dude.
Dude, you would totally come with me. I need a bodyguard for our adventures.
I would be like Lara Croft, except real. That would be majorly cool.
Totally. We'd have cars and boats and planes all over for instant escape. And no adults could tell us what to do.
Count me in. What would you do while I was bodyguarding you?
Maybe take pictures of our adventures. I would love to be a photographer. As if I ever could be.
What are you talking about? Max, you are a photographer. Your pictures could be in a museum. Someday they will. I believe in you. Thank you.
That took Chloe and me the whole day to draw. It's almost invisible now. William used to grill awesome burgers for us. I wonder if he was the last one to use this. Hey, I remember that stain. Chloe and I knocked over Joyce's wine bottle and we scrubbed forever, but it never came out. We got so busted. I guess they're aging, these books. I should be able to find the tools I need here. Nothing. This is so lame. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? Chloe's stepdad is a veteran and a security guard? He must really hate her. Yes! Score! Boom! Precision screwdrivers. Except, I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Man, I should have done that before they fell. Yes, you have mad skills, Max. What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this? Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy. I wonder why. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway. Shit! Butterfingers! Poor little dear.
It's not enough to kill you, they have to display your head. Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera. So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there. Hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
I wasn't sure.
I know I look a lot different.
I was scared too. I couldn't see straight.
I don't blame you, Max.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There's no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Absolutely. Nathan Prescott had a fucking gun on you.
Gutless prick. That was scary. Who did you tell?
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that phony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
This day couldn't get any stranger. This would be a great shot of Chloe dancing.
my moment, Max. Don't let it slip. Strike so many poses, girl. Rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
What's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this
door. I'm not a kid anymore. I can't hide under the bed. Where else?
I'm giving you exactly 3 seconds to open the door. 1, 2...
This is going nowhere fast.
Shit.
I better look someplace else.
What's going on in here? Why is she here?
None of your business.
I don't like strangers here.
Stop freaking. She's not a stranger. This is my friend.
Great. Another one of your friends. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh, yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order.
It's not my pot. It's from Max.
Is this true?
Yeah. My pot.
So you're bringing drugs into my home? How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do
you?
Get
the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win.
Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
Awesome sauce? Totally reminds me of when we were kids. Come on, Slowpoke!
Hold on. I haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa. This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today. I feel like I'm in my nightmare again. Birds are so lucky, they can always escape. Wowzer, Chloe drew that to mark our tree fort, so we'd always be able to find each other in case of emergency. Looks like the youth of Arcadia Bay still come up here to party. I never made it. How long has that been here? Sure you don't want to be alone?
Have a seat, Pete.
You're in a good mood.
Seeing my step dork get played makes me happy.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. She's cool. Only that prick would bully her.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
You know, I wanted to, but I realized I have enough mystery in my life.
I'd like to find out. I bet he's got some serious porn in there.
Ugh.
Good thing you didn't look. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
I knew you didn't know. Chloe, your house is under surveillance.
What are you talking about?
There are cameras all over the house. I saw it on a monitor in the garage.
I knew it! He is so hella fucking paranoid! I'll keep this a secret for now.
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
Even yours?
Not anymore.
So what do you have on Nathan?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
How much do you owe?
$3,000 plus interest. And before I could get a chunk of that from Nathan, he dosed my drink with some shit.
God, Chloe, I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Chloe, that is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Oh, good thing you notified the principal. I feel safer already.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass. What's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years. You just zoned.
No, I saw it.
I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But high, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning. Tell me everything.
Through the blizzard.